Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam. Welcome to episode number 23, Moments with the Qur'an. Today's moment comes from Surah Al-Anbiya, and in particular the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam that Allah mentions to us in this surah. We all know, brothers and sisters in Islam, that Ibrahim alayhi salam was tested from a very young age, for his own father made idols and worshipped them, and those idols were worshipped by the community as well. And for the life of him, Ibrahim could not understand what was going on. How can this be that my own father creates these idols and these idols can't benefit you or harm you, and then everybody worships these idols? It went against his being, right? His fitrah, his natural disposition. And we all know how, mashallah, he tried to make his father realize the error of his ways, and he asked respectfully clever questions, but all this was to no avail. And then a time came where he had a different opportunity, when everyone was going out to some event and fewer eyes will be or would have been on the place where all the idols were in. So Ibrahim alayhi salam took his opportunity. He went in and smashed all the idols and left the device used to smash the idols on the big one. He just left one, the biggest idol. He left that one and he put the device on that one and then he left. When the people came back, obviously this was a catastrophe for them. This was blasphemy. They were really angry. And immediately they started investigating the matter. And when they started asking the people who were there, who did this to our idols? They say it's some boy who we hear people call Ibrahim. Subhanallah. Which means to them, he was no one of importance. He wasn't famous in any way. But subhanallah, to Allah, he was famous. So they referred to him in this belittled way. So immediately, Ibrahim is brought forth to answer about these accusations. And when they ask him, he said, قَالَ بَلْ فَعَلَهُ كَبِيرُهُمْ هَذَا فَاسْأَلُوهُمْ إِن كَانُوا يَنطِقُونَ. Subhanallah. They said, did you do this to our idols, our gods, O Ibrahim? He said, instead, the big one did it. So ask them if they indeed can speak who did this to them. Now the question is, was this a lie? Was this a lie? Because he did it, but he said the big one did it. Now in the Sunnah, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about Ibrahim alaihi salam to the Sahaba and by default to us, because we receive his lessons, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, and this is the hadith of Abu Hurairah, which is in Sahih al-Bukhari, he mentions that Ibrahim didn't lie except three lies. And in this narration, he mentions this particular moment here, and he mentions another moment, and that was when, just before he smashed the idols, when the people were going out, they wanted to take him with them, and he says, I'm sick, inni saqim. He said, I'm sick, but he wasn't physically unwell, but he said this. And a third part was when he eventually left his people and he ended up in Egypt and he was married. And this tyrant king that was in Egypt, he practiced tyranny on people who had wives. So when he went into Egypt and he was asked, who is this lady? He, instead of saying she's my wife, he said she's my sister. And obviously he did this to protect the sanctity of his marriage. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions this. There's another narration which is in Sahih Muslim, which is the famous narration of Shafa'ah, in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaches us about, you know, the difficulties of the day of Qiyam and how people will be rushing from prophet to prophet, asking them to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek intercession on their behalf. And every prophet will say, Allah is so angry today, he was never angry like this before and he will never be angry like this after, go to someone else. And then eventually they'll get to Ibrahim alaihi salam, who is the father of the prophets, and he will say, no, I can't because of these lies. But he mentions a different lie than the three mentioned. He mentions when he traveled out of his place before he went to Egypt, he went to Sham, the Levant, and over there he found people worshipping the cosmos, the stars and the moon and the sun and so on and so forth. And over there he said, Hadha Rabbi, meaning the star is my Lord, or the moon is my Lord, or the sun is my Lord. But he wasn't saying it out of belief. He was again saying it to make them realize the error of their ways, right? So are these lies, and why are they called lies? Why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say Ibrahim didn't lie except three lies? The reality, brothers and sisters in Islam, these are not lies. What these are, in Arabic it's called al-ma'arid or at-tawriyah, right? And this refers to the concept of pun or playing on words, where you speak in a particular way whereby two meanings are generated, a closer meaning and a further meaning, and you intend the further meaning, so you're not lying, but someone else understands the closer meaning. So to them you are lying. So based on this, it's called a lie, but it's not really a lie as we know a lie to be from an Islamic perspective, or the definition of a lie that we know is totally haram and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes and the punishment is severe. This is totally different. So for example, when he said, I'm sick, he wasn't physically unwell, but no doubt, he was sick of them worshipping idols. So he says, I'm sick. Inni saqim. I'm sick, right? So they understood something, he meant something. This is called tawriya or al-ma'arid, or this concept of pun and playing on words. When he went to Egypt, for example, and he said, she's my sister, right? She's my sister in humanity. She's my sister in faith. He meant something, they understood something else. And no doubt, even if he properly lied here, he wouldn't be sinful. Because when two harms meet, and we spoke about this in our previous episodes, when we spoke about the story of Musa and Khidr alayhi salam, when there's two harms, you have two situations, both are harmful, right? You have a bad situation and a worse situation. What should you do? Right? We said that the Sharia teaches us to practice the lesser harm to avert the greater harm. So even if he lied, totally lied and said she's my sister, then this would be the lesser harm in light of the greater harm that would have come about if he said that she's my wife. Right, so this is again tawriya. It's tawriya, but we're saying in this matter, even if it wasn't, he's totally fine, Ibrahim alayhi salam, because this lies from a Sharia perspective is absolutely fine. For example, somebody's life is in danger, and then they run into your home, and they're hiding, and then your door is knocked, and the killer says, "Is this person in your home?" And you lie totally, and you say, "No, he's not in my home." This is a total lie. There's no, it's very difficult to fathom two meanings here. This is a blatant lie. So over here, the Sharia says you're not sinful. And in fact, you are rewarded for this lie. Why? Because you saved the loss of life. Lying is bad, but dying, loss of life is worse, right? So this is a circumstance. And obviously in the third circumstance, when he told them, ask the big one, or the big one did it. The big one did it. This here is also a type of tawriya. Why? Because he's using it in the form of getting them to think, getting them to stop the greater harm of shirk, right? And this is absolutely fine from a Sharia perspective in speech, right? He didn't say, I didn't do it. He said, the big one did it. And indirectly, the big one did it, meaning these idols did it to themselves. If they weren't being worshipped, they wouldn't have been broken. So there's some play here on the words. Right, and from a Sharia perspective, this is not an outright lie. And in the context of bringing about the truth and deleting a falsehood, this kind of speech is permissible. So this is the answer to this dilemma that many people ask about, that did Ibrahim alayhi salam lie? Now, from an Islamic perspective, as we see in the hadith of Kulthum, right, in which she mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam permitted lying in three circumstances, and all these three circumstances we find it's to avert harm, and in the process you are not taking away anyone's rights. Number one, during war, right? Al harbu khud'a, war is deception. The opposition's trying to deceive you. You also have to do what you need to do to ensure that you save life and your army has the least losses. So sometimes a message is sent out that gives the impression that your attack will be in the morning and then you attack at night, and so on and so forth. Number two, for example, when you are trying to create harmony between two fighting parties, right? So one party comes to you and says, you know what, this person is like this and like this and like this, and they say this about me, and this is what they're telling people. And you know that that person is doing that. You know that that person does hate this person, and what this person is telling you is true. But to calm the situation and fix the situation, you say, no, inshallah, it's not as you think. You know, previously I heard that he likes you and he loves you and he thinks highly of you, and so on and so forth, in the event of extinguishing the flames of anger and hopefully bringing the two parties together. In this circumstance, as we see in the hadith of Kulthum, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam permitted this. And in the third circumstance, it's between spouses, when spouses are they avoid being totally honest with each other, and in the process it builds their relationship. So for example, you know, he's not dressed so smartly, or she's not dressed so smartly, but you put it aside and she asks, you know, how am I dressed? Or he asked, how am I dressed? Say, alhamdulillah, mashallah, right? Or maybe the food lacks a bit of salt that day, normally it's perfect, and you say, no, the food is absolutely perfect, mashallah, tabarakallah, Allah bless you and Allah protect your hands, that the hands that cook this food. Alhamdulillah, this is absolutely fine as per the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But note here, brothers and sisters in Islam, in all these circumstances and situations, no one is taking away anyone's rights, right? In all three circumstances, the war circumstance, the fixing problems between two party circumstances, and the situation between husband and wife, no one is taking anyone's rights. And that's why even the scholars say, if it's a matter of rights, then you can't lie, even if it's between spouses, right? It's between spouses. Like, for example, you promise your wife as part of the marriage agreement a certain amount, and then you give the amount in kind. Right, you don't give the actual amount, and then you inflate the price of whatever you're giving, a dress or some jewelry, you inflate the price, right? So that you can come out of this agreement between you and your spouse. This is not allowed. This is not a lie that is permissible. Why? Because here you're taking the rights of someone. Anyway, the lesson has gone above the norms that we have become used to, but nonetheless, the lesson is very important. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Salamullahi alaykum wa rahmatuhu wa barakatuhu.